by the six countries?
The memorandum came later. But you see, as I told you, it is easy for us to shift. So even in the absence of memorandum, we immediately, in my AOR, I immediately declared that we have to continue with our full alert and shift our personnel from the cemetery and concentrate in the different areas where people converge, and also to be ready with our task forces as far as Pandakan oil.
And was there a specific order from Bacalso, General Bacalso, in this regard?
Yeah, there
was. When the travel advisories came?
Yeah, there was subsequently, there was a memorandum.
Okay. What about you, Asec, from the DOT, Asec Bengzon? What kind of information do you have, and how are you reacting to these travel advisories?
For the information on the threat level, we rely principally on our police and military authorities. What we are constantly monitoring would be the issuance of the travel advisories coming from the governments that have issued them. So more importantly, what we'd like to monitor would be the movement of tourists from those source markets and try to find out if there are any cancellations or any effects on the movement.
Okay, and when you do get these travel advisories as a Philippine government, do you have a right to challenge or to question the basis of the issuances of these travel advisories? And can you ask them to divulge to you what is the basis of the issuance of the travel advisories?
Well, first of all, we recognize the fact that the issuance of travel advisories is part of the regular functions of the various embassies. Mm-hmm. Of course, on the part of the DOT, it's incumbent upon us to make representation either directly or through the DFA to have the travel advisories either removed or downgraded.
Mm-hmm. And so, what did you do?
Well, in the case of the DOT, what we've done basically is monitoring, because the representation with the respective governments or embassies is under the purview of the Department of Foreign Affairs.
And did you check exactly whether these countries that issued travel advisories had cancellations?
Well, the bit of good news is that we've been monitoring the movement since last week. And fortunately, there have been no reports of any cancellations of major tour groups coming to the Philippines.
Okay, thank you very much, Asec Bengzon. Congressman Bizaon, what do you make of all of these replies of our guests here, your co-guests,
yes,
and your take on how government is handling the supposed travel advisories based on a wide range of information that these countries have evaluated?
There are a lot of questions raised by the circumstances when we got these travel advisories. Number one, my question is that how come this came out on the heels of the discovery of that bomb threat from Yemen to the U.S., discovered in Dubai, discovered in London, I understand. The question is, if we now relate to that, the latest remarks from London, that there is nothing new, this is a rehash of previous travel advisories. Mm-hmm. 1 year ago, mm-hmm, there was such a travel advisory. So how come this came on the heels of that discovery? And maybe driven to think that, is there an attempt, is this an attempt to divert the attention of people from that fact that there indeed was a credible threat? Obama, or President Obama, used the term, a credible threat to the United States in terms of this. There are also other questions. I am not saying that we should disregard this. We must continue to evaluate, analyze, monitor what this report is all about. Now, question, is the travel advisory based on an analysis of the direction of the threat? I would ask, because there are two possible levels. One is domestic threat, and the other one is is an international threat. And I would assume that since there is this report from the five or six countries, travel advisories from five or six countries, I would assume that the threat is coming from outside. Now, if they have this information, I think it is their obligation to all their allies in this global war against terrorism to be provided specific information. So that is the reason why I say that I think the president's main concern when he goes to APEC and talk to these allied countries, not to focus so much on the lifting of the travel advisories, but on asking these countries who may have in possession of, who may be in possession of specific information, if this is a credible threat, we must be provided those specific informations by these allied countries so that we may counter-check it, or we may, and if we find it to be credible, really, we must know from what direction the threat is coming.
Okay, so is there a protocol, Congressman Bizaon, where countries can share intelligence information?
Yes, that is mandated by a protocol agreement in the United Nations. And even there is even a one such protocol existing among the ASEAN countries for the exchange of information. You know, I am wondering, why the Philippines? Look, there is an APEC summit conference in Tokyo. I would anticipate a report or indications that there could be a threat there. Mm-hmm. Bali is still here. Thailand has its own share of secessionists in southern Thailand coming from, I'm not saying that, you know, Islam is
okay. You mentioned two countries. Yes. Tokyo, there is an APEC meeting. There's a G20 summit in Korea, in South Korea. So what are you trying to say?
I would expect caution, at least, to be raised. Because they could be a target of global terrorism. That's what they want, remember? Mm-hmm. Another question I am raising is this. The report is that targeted to ambassadors? That's an unusual target for terrorists. Terrorists' target normally is inflicting the maximum damage, inflict casualties. If they say the target is a mall, I would readily accept it. Or the LRT or MRT, I would readily accept it. But two ambassadors?
What if they're changing their tactics altogether now and create, maybe it is one person, but one person representing big interests? We can debate on that. We'll get back to your point with many questions that you've raised. We still have our guests here from the tourism, Asec Bengzon, General Rongavilla from the Manila Police District, and from the Ninoy Aquino International Airport, the head of the police there.